are sehr gut.
Hey everybody, Roger here. I want to talk to you guys today about about ethno-states and this growing idea, this growing desire for people who are populations who are angry at each other, groups that are angry at each other that just feel like the only way out is to go ahead and start your own ethno-state. There's a lot of things that are very extreme these days that, you know, even the possibility of something like this could happen. So anyways, with that said, there's a lot of people who are thinking in terms of racial divide.
Right, like if we never had to deal with these people, how much more advanced would we be?
Well, I mean, it was brought up in this chat, the difference between the optimistic view of the future that was taken in the 50s and 60s. Like if you look at the way I thought of this is if you look at 50s and 60s sci-fi, if you look at what was expected of the future, what was expected of right now, you know, nobody was expecting nigger tech.
Right, they're expecting
fucking starships and replicators. And
I there was some predictions of nigger tech if you look at some of them, but the prediction of nigger tech got
communicator.
The prediction of nigger tech got more prevalent as it got closer in time to now. Like
we're not going to be able to, you know, there's going to be some people who are not going to be willing to move, while some of these people who want this total ethno state, these total ethno states, are saying, well, to those people, we would either try to pay them out to move, and some of them would probably take it, or we would allow them to stay, but the majority of them would have to leave. Well, it still doesn't answer a lot of questions. You know, you're most likely going to have conflict. That's what the assumption is, in my opinion, and I think it is for a couple of people who have also discussed this as well. So, anyways, we see a lot of people like, you know, there's. You guys have seen my, I already predicted it, and it would be my worst video, or my most downgraded video. What does Black Panther mean to me?
What? You don't say. You don't say. You don't say!
There are a lot of people on there who are living in the fantasy of what Africa is or is not. You know, I tend to side more with, I want heroes that can actually do something in Africa to solve, you know, the disparity of hunger, the disparity of war and the slave trade. You know, that country has a lot to answer to its people, and it has not done much. So that's where I see real superheroes, when people are going to be out there doing something to solve those problems. However, going back to the main portion of this, of my example here, in Twitter, you know, all over Twitter, I've been looking at a lot of the tweets and regarding just Black Panther, and they're saying, this is for our people. One person wrote a tweet basically saying we don't need any white people's opinions about this movie. I'm only bringing this up as an example here because they're just the exact polar equivalent to what white people are saying, what some white nationalists are saying. Some white nationalists are saying, you know, we can't gel, you know, we all are, everybody in every race apparently has different tendencies as an ethnicity, I guess.
What most white people are is naturally racist, and it has to be conditioned out of them every generation. But brown people will be racist against white people by default, and it will require intense conditioning to stop that. Just look at all human behavior in all time. It's always been this way.
So we're all inherently racist is what this particular article is basically stating. And I'm like, well, no, that's not true. I mean, some people, I personally don't think that's true. I'm not a racist. I never have been. I like everybody equally. The thing that I judge on is character. And I think if we morph people to start thinking about character first and foremost, we'd be judging by that. That's the only thing people should be judged on, is their character. So, sometimes I have bad character. I admit that. Anyways, where I'm going with all of this is this, you know, look at how a chef operates. A chef is able to concoct anything with any ingredient and make it all blend very well, but he's going to do it through trial and error. Obviously, a good chef will always have trial and error at hand. You know, they're always going to be messing up on a dish and having to recreate it until it's just perfect. that's the same thing with all of us as civilians in the United States. We basically just need to start working with each other. We haven't had a long time in our lifetime to actually see if something's going to work for us. If this blend is going to work for us, you know, blending all of the ethnicities. We have not had a lot of time to do that, and now we're going to give up, or a lot of these people are thinking about giving up. I mean, that's not what people do. We're not meant to give up. We're meant to keep going. And again, chemical compounds. When you mix certain chemical compounds, you sometimes get great stuff, like beer.
Yo, guys, I brought some Victory Queer Beer.
Yeah! So anyways, I guess where I'm going with all this is this. Ethno-states are a way of giving up. That's how I personally look at it. Yes, there's going to be bad seeds, and it doesn't mean that I am saying, no, we don't need to be following laws. If anything is going to be a threat, we're not going to be stupid and not be aware of it and not do anything about it. We're going to be aware of it. We're going to do something about it. And we're going to make sure that people who should not be let in are not going to be let in. And people who do want to come in, show that they can actually give back to the United States and give back to us all in... give back to the community and spread that to their children, their kin, their brothers and sisters. You know, that's what America might not have originally been founded on, but in a way it kind of was, and that's what it's morphed into at this point in time. We've morphed it into something that's actually working. There might be some people who just want to give up now and believe that, you know, having just a jar of peanut butter... white people having just a jar of peanut butter for the rest of their lives, one flavor of something in their little state, their little ethno-nation state, is going to be satisfying. It's not. You know, we're all like spices and herbs and again, chemical compounds and ingredients. We all work together best, and we can create something really good when we blend it all together. When we separate ourselves, that's when, you know, in my opinion, I've never liked just single anything around. I like having that blend. I think it helps with understanding one another and getting a good grasp of who we all are and a little bit more love for each other. So, anyways, what do you guys think? Am I on track, or I'm probably a little off as well as usual? Just wanted to get your guys' opinion. Hope you guys have a great day. Bye bye.
I don't feel best about it on the Wednesday. This amorphinist hat the corruption in unserem Staat möglich gemacht. Und jetzt das. Verrat an meiner Person. An meiner Person. Ich will, dass Göring sofort entmachtet wird und alle Ämter aufgibt. Für den Fall, dass ich den Krieg nicht überstehe, ist der Mann auf der Stelle hinzurichten.